little article here from DJ Mag. Obviously, with the dawning of the clubs being reopened on June 21st, everyone's mostly focused on the people like myself who are going to be maybe behind the booth, behind the decks or on the dance floor. But there's a lot of people surrounding, you know, the nighttime industry and all that malarkey who work in the background week to week, kind of making sure these places are, you know, viable for us to enter in, who are definitely going to be in for a bit of a, I won't say a culture shock, but it's going to be a little bit, it's going to take some getting used to, right, to be in a enclosed area with loads of strangers and all that malarkey and all the tension and the kind of debauchery that occurs in nighttime after all these months spent at home. And DJ may kind of catalog some of these insights courtesy of this article here. It says how club workers are feeling about the return of events as the UK looks forward to the end of lockdown and the reopening of clubs and festivals. Julia Botoro speaks to nightlife workers from different parts of the industry to paint a complex picture of their excitement and worry about the future and the particularly of their mental health. Yeah, you didn't really hear too tough right beforehand. So maybe this is another good kind of unintended consequence of the lockdown. People kind of taking more of a serious look at some of the mental health aspects that affect people in and around nightlife, especially the people that are just involved in it day to day. We hear a lot about people, entertainers and artists, and the pressures around that, but the people that actually work in it day to day definitely need our support in that regard too. So the article says the following. Ollie Clark is out delivering Amazon parcels around Bristol in spring 2020. He's one of many workers that the Royal Mail hired during the beginning of the coronavirus pandemic as the public moves to shopping online during the first lockdown. Clark's new day job is far cry from his pre-pandemic life, where he was assistant manager at a 300 capacity basement club, Basement 45. As UK government struggled to manage the first wave of COVID-19 in the UK, he has no idea when the venue will reopen. Just imagine how much of a, I guess that's what adults do, especially if you rent to pay, you just kind of figure stuff out. But imagine how much of a shock that must have been to the identity, to go from being the assistant manager of a pretty well-known, you know, 300 capacity, I guess, club in Bristol. I've never been to that place, but I'd imagine it's pretty well regarded within the scene, to go from that to suddenly delivering Amazon parcels. Like, that must be a bit of a shock, isn't it? Your whole identity is wrapped up in being the kind of basement guy, and then suddenly you're having to pivot to delivering parcels. Is like, oof, it takes a lot, innit? I guess it's a good thing, because the only silver lining would be that a lot of the people that work within nightlife, I would imagine, come from humble origins, right? They've kind of bounced around from job to job, so it's not really a big deal in terms of going, having to do a certain thing in order to kind of allow you, because that's the kind of premise that people have when they do Ibiza residencies, right? When you do that thing. The idea behind that is that you kind of work there for a certain period of time, save some money, and then you kind of spend the rest of the time sort of enjoying yourself, right? But there's an idea of like seasonal workers, right? So maybe when you're back home, you might do some factory work to allow you then to go out and maybe, you know, party and work that way. So maybe that's the only silver lining of it, but that must have been a bit of a culture shock, to say the least. It continues, it says, I knew I wanted to come back to this role at Basement 45. I didn't want to leave the industry at all. I have such a passion for it, Clark told DJ Mag a year later in spring 2021. The government says saying they want to retrain, but I'm training this industry of events and bigger nightclubs. I've put a lot of effort into it, for sure. They said the government's furlough scheme wasn't enough for him to survive on over the years, so he has been taking odd jobs while waiting for the restrictions to ease. Aside from Royal Mail, he has worked for a meat factory and at bars. He is now counting down the days to June 21st. Many clubbers are eager to hit the dance floor once coronavirus restrictions ease, but if the pre-event excitement turns into nervousness, they can sell their tickets and stay at home. When the lockdowns are lifted, nightlife workers won't have such a simple choice, sorry. If the people are overwhelmed about going back to working the events after a year of lockdown, furlough and extended unemployment is not as easy as saying just quit. On top of trying to cover their finances and careers, being part of a live music industry is often tied to someone's identity and values, with colleagues sometimes feeling like a second family. Of course, that's what I'm saying. So just imagine how much dread and excitement they're feeling. Combination, it must be a really odd feeling going back there. It continues here, says the balancing the need to earning a living with physical and mental health risk of return to work during a pandemic is a dilemma that's facing tens of thousands of nightlife workers. So how are they preparing themselves for the end of lockdown and the reopening of the venues? Lockdowns will be lifted across the UK in stages. England has set June 21st as a date to drop all restrictions, though at the same time of writing, Wales, North Ireland and Scotland hadn't specified when clubs will reopen. The nightlife industry has been hit harder than other parts of hospitality. A report by the all-party parliamentary group published in February found that UK clubs had cut 51% of their jobs since the pandemic started. Mamma mia. 51% of jobs have been cut since the pandemic started. that's a whole lot of people, isn't it? That's why there's a lot of figures and articles coming out at the moment saying that a lot of these kind of service or this industry, these hospitality industry jobs are sort of struggling for staff, because now that the world is, or the UK is slowly opening up, people are going back to their regular day jobs, and leaving those things behind, like, you know, bars and pubs and clubs and stuff. So they're having to fill these spots and they just don't have the staff at the moment. So if you've ever wanted to get in and working at your kind of cool bar or whatever it may be, this is definitely the best time to kind of get your foot in the door, for sure, because there's not a lot of people really to kind of take those jobs. 51% of the jobs, and while bars and pubs have asked 32% and 25% of their staff respectively. People's expectations and the unknown have increased their levels of anxiety in a massive way, says Sylviana Keel, Director of Operations at the Nighttime Industries Association. The pandemic has been a fantastic hub of unanswered questions, with people just not knowing 1 month to next what's around the corner. The uncertainty is causing stress with venues and staff alike. Duncan McBean organises club nights in a pub in Forest, Scotland, and he says it's been particularly difficult for smaller venues, which it's just detrimental for the music community at local level. He says it can be disheartening. Even the council doesn't have answers for me. People have been messaging me throughout the year wondering when we can get back to it, saying that they didn't realize how much the events meant to them. For sure, that's what I've been doing. It's not just in-house staff that lack the clarity. There are hundreds of thousands of freelancers, artists and working in the nightlife industry who had even more uncertain year than the furloughed peers. Robert Elliott is a live freelance lighting designer working in various London venues as well as UK international festivals. It has been dynamic and freelance. I'm used to a bit of uncertainty. I kind of like it, but this is another level. It's a good time to have some off time, as a pandemic, the music industry never stops, but the unsteady times made it hard to enjoy. Exactly, man. Just imagine what it's like being a flipping flyer designer, right? The person that designs flyers for club events. Imagine that person. You're probably spitting out flyers out of your ass, like, you know, a couple of hundred per month, maybe more per year, and now suddenly, boom, done. No one's asking you for artwork. No one's asking you for JPEG or PNG files, or, you know, whatever, like mock-ups, like nothing. God damn it. While so many have spent this past year at home, it's not necessarily been a restful period. Booking events into the calendar is creating conversations about social and health anxiety. While some people are excited to return to some sort of normality, others are more cautious. Corrigan is an artist and former employee of Glasgow's Sub Club. She worked in different roles, including bartending and lighting. And she says, I still feel uncomfortable about the no social distancing, but I'm sure I'll relax in time once I see for myself when it's going. When it's time for that stage. I feel some sort of reluctance getting close to people right now. I'm much more sensitive of noise recently and have to make sure I've always have earplugs. Nightclubs can be intense and I'm expecting to feel anxious as I've done such little socializing. I even get anxious going to a supermarket these days, and that's something that I've kind of said ad nauseum to everyone that will listen to me, but I'm very skeptical about this idea that all of these events are going to be jam-packed and everyone's going to be overflowing in the streets and it's going to be the return of a new dawn of raving. I think there's going to be a lot of excitement, obviously, the first couple of weeks, first couple of months, but then it's going to slowly but surely peter out. I think people's sensitivity to being in close proximity areas like that, as you mentioned, having sensitivity to noise, to people, has definitely changed during our time and during COVID. And people's maybe outlook and what they kind of desire for their life has definitely changed. Because for as much as I want to return back to club, and I think some people might just be like, you know what, that might be a sign for me to kind of move on to other things. So those people aren't necessarily going to be running back to the club at the first thought, right? They're going to be going to other things that they want to maybe go to. So I think this idea that everything is going to be sold out and people should jump, that's why I was kind of hesitant about putting on my own event that I was planning on doing. I've kind of felt like, I just kind of just see how it goes the first couple of months and then we can go from there. And I'm in no doubt, obviously, by Christmas, you'll definitely see a more concentrated group of actual ravers outdoors as opposed to general consumers. I don't think you'll see the heady days of Liverpool Street being packed full of just tourists just eager to go out on a lash and stuff. I think it's going to be a lot more tamer than what it was prior, I think, going forward. Of course, I could be wrong, but I definitely think people's sensitivity and overall outlook when it comes to these kind of things has definitely changed forever. It continues, it says, these feelings were echoed by Andre Dack, owner and manager of Ramsgate Music Hall in Kent. He said that he probably feels strange to be among crowds with restrictions in place. He says, it's such a unique scenario. and I don't know how I react to being immersed in crowds until I'm there. I'm more concerned about making other people feel at ease, the staff and the audience, once they return to the venues. I've not thought about myself. I've suffered from anxiety throughout my adult life, which is unfortunate, but it also means I've got a pretty firm grasp on what triggers it. Everyone's struggling out here, isn't it? Oh, look at that. Lovely bar. Continues here, says Gemma Midlich, operation manager at London Club E1, says the start of the outdoor events in April has allowed her to be a more of a gradual return to a job. She says, I've been lucky because I've had a soft launch of being back to work with these daytime things. I've not got going straight in the deep end, and I feel like this has definitely helped. If I hadn't done this, probably I would have been more anxious. Some are concerned about keeping the health habits they've been developing over lockdown. Elizabeth, a bartender in London, said she's been keen on getting more sleep and stressed about returning to tough schedules of nightlife. She says, before I used to accept more that I can do, so maybe I've learned that I'll just have to give myself more breaks. I just have to be kinder to myself and follow my body, because I only have one. That's definitely true, isn't it, right? The healthier habits people have developed, going to bed at a certain time, eating a specific diet, maybe going on walks, exercising more, you know, whatever, reading, mental health stuff, meditating, doing less drugs, all that sort of stuff, has probably been a good thing for most people. So having to kind of go back to that scene where you're kind of coaxed into doing those more nefarious things, and you're put around more temptation that isn't probably the most healthiest thing for you, isn't going to be a good thing. But you know, who knows? It continues, says that's exactly what Rosa Ramon, a recovery coach and member of the Music Industry Therapist Collective, advised nightlife workers to do. She says, it's an opportunity to practice consent in a way. What have you learned about yourself and your needs over this period? How can you support yourself or ask for the help that you need? What can you do for others after you've been to work? Can you implement a self-care routine that doesn't look like grabbing a bottle or a bag? Just really take care of yourself, attending to those persons who frightened or overwhelmed when they have to go back after the global trauma that we've been through, into a situation which is now a complete opposite. While some worry about the physical toll on nightlife, others are reflecting on the impact of their free time. Although it's nothing new that this industry doesn't really work with unsociable hours, it means that this year's workers won't get to enjoy the end of lockdown everyone else. The people that are serving, oh true, I never thought about that, that's a very good point. The people that are serving the drinks and making sure that everything is working also haven't seen their friends. She says, was that Raoul Edward Richness, the manager of The Lion and Lamb, a London pub that doubles a music venue? We aren't open on Mondays and Tuesdays, so I won't go back to work then, that's fine. But all of my friends work Mondays and Tuesdays. It's that balance between being able to see your friends at any point and also wanting to do the best for your company you work for. It's going to be very difficult. He talked about a sense of isolation for hospitality workers, which he feels has persevered as more risky to hang out with because contact with public. Says, I understand people's reaction. He says, I don't blame anyone for anything right now, but at the same time, for the people that are working in pubs and bars and clubs, it does get way heavier on our mind. You think, good God, people don't want to see me, I should just do something else now. Why am I working in a pub if it means that I can't see my family? It's something that almost, if you're not working in a bar, I think you wouldn't really understand. It's quite difficult to talk about with housemates or friends, for sure. You know what I mean? Everyone's working a conventional 9-to-5 remotely at home and stuff, got a flexible schedule, and here you are back out on the front line, you know, serving drinks and making sure you're keeping, you know, strangers' girls' ponytails out of their mouth whilst they vomit into really spotty toilets. But yeah, long article there, you can read the rest of it. But yeah, it's going to be an epic time on the dance floors again. I think for those of us that are able to go out, you know, don't take it for granted. Use that time wisely. Thank the people that are there. Tip people well. Don't be asking people for flipping guest list spots when you go out and stuff. You know, pay the entry fee that needs to be paid in order to get in, and just enjoy it for what it is, because there's no really telling. You know, we've already given these governments too much control over our civil liberties. There's no real telling, you know, when that will get taken away from us again. So don't take it for granted. Enjoy it for what it is at the moment it's given to you. Make the best of it. Look after your friends and people around you and stuff, and then go from there. Just go from there.